I'm a long COVID sufferer who has been on LDN for 4 weeks, now up to 1.5 milligram and experiencing amazing increase in energy for more than 24 hours and considering going on to 3 times a week. In order to also address my osteoarthritis, should I think of increasing the dose or just continue and look for possible results in 8 or many months? Okay. So with the long COVID protocols, and again, we talked about long COVID a lot at COVID was in everybody's conversation during the last Research Trust conference. And by the way, you don't have to be a pharmacist. You don't have to be a provider. You don't, if you're a patient and you have a lot of questions about that, you can go out to the LDNresearchtrust.org website and you can literally listen to the previous conferences as well as search for a lot of information. And long COVID is something we have a lot of information on. There's a lot of science and research being done on long COVID specifically. And because of how this virus literally turns off some of those protective mechanisms. There's two mechanisms that we learned that are literally turned off by this virus that then potentiates the inflammation and the susceptibility to this virus. And some people have more susceptibility because of their pre-existing issues, increased inflammation, maybe they have diabetes or other issues. And you, if you have osteoarthritis, you are inflamed because osteoarthritis can be an autoimmune issue, but it could also be due to injury. But either way, there's a lot of inflammation. So LDN will help reduce that inflammation. It's about your success, not necessarily the dose. So if you're at 1.5 milligram and you're doing well, why not just stay there for a little bit? I mean, I don't see the point in increasing. It ain't broke, so don't fix it. I mean, that's kind of a funny way to look at it. But if it is working for you, leave it there. Because even at 1.5 milligram, it will address the inflammation associated with osteoarthritis, as well as the long COVID. So LDN is one tool that we use for long COVID. We also talked about melatonin and a little bit about vitamin D and the types of vitamin D to use, as well as omegas and in some situations peptides, and in some other situations there's other medications that can be used. So it's really about the functional medicine practitioner that is able to really hone in on your specific set of issues associated with long COVID. Many people are suffering from long COVID, and the root issue is similar, but their symptoms can be quite vast and can vary dramatically. So I don't want to minimize what you're going through, because I just don't think you have to get to 4 milligram or 4.5 milligram if 1.5 is working for you. You may find that 1.5 milligrams twice a day might be even more helpful. And how you know is what's going on with your energy, what's going on with your symptoms. And if those are, again, your energy is going up and your symptoms are going on, then you're hitting it right where you should.
I have been taking LDN since February. These are dissolvable tablets that dissolve 0.5 mLs, tapering very slowly, and now on a capsule the last 2 months of 4.5 milligrams. I have started to get some soreness return in my legs, all from long COVID fatigue and pain. Would I need to increase higher dose? Great question. When COVID comes on, a lot of people did need to readjust their dose. Not even for LDN, even hormones needed to be a readjust, right? Because a virus just attacked your body, and so different things are always changing. So yes, we saw actually a lot of patients adjust their dose even after they had COVID they adjusted their dose, either higher or lower, depending on what their symptoms were and what they were feeling. And then some of them even did twice a day dosing while they had COVID and then dropped back down. So it kind of depends on where you are in this COVID phase. It looks like you've been taking 4.5 for the last 2 months. I don't know when you got COVID, but I have seen that very frequently where patients have jumped up to twice a day during COVID and during if they had a long COVID phase and then dropped back down after they felt like they were back on maintenance. So yes, with COVID, there's a lot of things that change just with LDN. So yes, your dose more than likely needs to be adjusted.
What's your experience using LDN to help damage to the autonomic nervous system following long COVID? Does LDN mask the symptoms or help cure the damage? Neither. LDN doesn't mask anything. It does work along the pro-inflammatory pathways to reduce those chemicals that actually cause the inflammation. LDN doesn't cure anything. You remove the LDN and all of that comes right back. So it will work while you have LDN on board. And once you take it away, that benefit is gone. It doesn't mask the symptoms. So it's not a Band-Aid. It actually does work right at those areas where we have the pro-inflammatory cytokines that are causing the inflammation, and those are reduced. But we also see where LDN will bind to those pain receptors to actually minimize our ability or our feeling of pain. But when we have long COVID, it also helps to reduce inflammation at the cellular level. So where those inflammatory areas are happening, it's usually on the cell wall or within the mitochondria inside that powerhouse of the cell, and LDN will work right there. So while you have LDN on board, you can actually affect what's happening and usually minimize the symptoms associated with long COVID. That isn't masking it. That's actual real work that's happening. It doesn't cure anything. You literally take LDN away and you could literally stop like that, but everything will come back in time.